Hare Krishna. So you are curious about whether your pronunciation of the standard ISKCON Sanskrit prayers and songs is okay or not. That's wonderful, and I'm sure that the videos you're about to watch will provide to you the guidance you need. I'm Nityananda Das, and Sanskrit has been my service for more than 15 years. So I'm very happy to have this chance of serving you by demonstrating practically the proper pronunciation and chanting of these wonderful Sanskrit verses we all know so well. Now, please watch this video till the end, because I will tell you something very important before you even start watching the actual demos and tutorials, so you can get the most out of them. ISKCON, a huge worldwide movement that consists of people from every possible country in the world. It is definitely easy to lose or even not find the correct pronunciation, as every one of us brings pronunciation traits and accents from our native languages. I mean, we've heard things like Hey Rad, Hey Vraja Devi K, instead of the correct one, Hey Rad, Hey Vraja Devi K. So that's an example of an accent. Now, people also create their own conventions of how things should sound. Very often you hear Nama Om Vishnu Padaya or Namaste Narasinghaya, where the correct way of pronouncing it, even in singing, would be Nama Om or Namaste. The first na should be short. Now someone could come and say, come on, this is singing. Don't burden us with these rules of Sanskrit. It's bhakti, from the heart. Pronunciation is not important. Okay, Prabhu, that's not important. But let's assume, for example, you are a native English speaker and somebody who is very close to you comes on your birthday and sings, Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to. How would you feel? Yes, it's cute, especially if the person sang it with love. But it's also true that if you'd point out to the person that it's pronounced as happy birthday, he or she would definitely listen to you and try to adopt the proper way of pronouncing English words to make you even happier. Same love. And love will find its way to show itself in all areas of reciprocation. So we love Prabhupada, previous acharyas, Krishna and his incarnations. And many songs written in their praise happen to be in Sanskrit. So, motivated by that same love, let's try to make those songs sound the way they were meant to, for the pleasure of whom they glorify. And I think this would be the right devotional mood with which we can approach what I'm about to show you. So, take it as your loving offering, or as a type of austerity of speech, the result of which you offer to Krishna. Another thing I wanted to add is that there is a great traditional spiritual singing in India. For example, Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, Madhva Sampradaya, Vallabha Sampradaya. They all have many Sanskrit texts, just like us, that they regularly chant and sing, and their pronunciation standards are very good. And they do maintain the main principles of Sanskrit pronunciation, such as long and short vowels, etc., even in singing. It is all a question of how you arrange the syllables of a verse in a given rhythmic structure of a song. And we'll talk about it a lot in the upcoming videos practically. So I firmly believe that the existing ISKCON devotees can learn, preserve, and teach the correct Sanskrit pronunciation, chanting, and singing. At least the basic prayers that all devotees are supposed to know. So, in these tutorials, we will first of all cover the Sanskrit verses and songs that are found in the BBT book Songs of the Vaishnava Acharyas. And then we'll add some other prayers and stotras that are also being sung by devotees on special occasions. So if you find these videos helpful, make sure to leave your generous likes and also subscribe to my channel. It will encourage me a lot and help me to put out more things for you. And before you proceed to the first demo video, I wanted to inform you that I have very detailed and well-structured online video courses on Sanskrit pronunciation and chanting. As of now, hundreds of people, including many ISKCON devotees from more than 50 countries, have been taking them, and they are super happy with what and how they learned. The courses have many hours of video and other instructional material to offer, including my personal feedback. So make sure you follow the link to my website in the description of each video and check it out for yourself. Okay, so it's time to go on now, and I'll see you in the next video. Hare Krishna!